Hello, Internet. We played a little bit of Dave the Diver off stream, and by a little bit, I mean a really little bit. Just enough to get that rapper, Sammy, his food, and as I suspected, his little Spicy Tuna Roll song played again. So that's done. I don't have to worry about getting copyright struck on YouTube if I upload this later, as long as we don't get any other rap songs. We also found out that that rapper Sammy was Otto, our farmer dude's son, and they're pretty happy to be reunited after 8 years. So yay, there you go, there's a story you guys missed. Oh yeah, we also made, what was it, sea urchin seaweed rice for the sea people to convince them that I can make good use of their seaweed farm. So now we're good. We also trained everyone a little bit because we had some extra cash lying around. I accidentally trained Itsuki, the ninja, a little bit more than everyone else. So soon she's going to get a giant charisma boost. But that's after everyone else gets trained up to get the same level as she is. Anyway, so unlike normally, we don't start on the boat. We're going to start by serving sushi. Here we go. Oh, why'd I grab the order for someone on the other side of the... It's gonna be okay. We're also serving up a bunch of blue tangs on the menu tonight. Because, you know, we got a ton of them. Oh, there are dishes. There we go. Hey, Vopker. How's it going? It's... hey? As always, could be better, but not terrible. We made like 5,000 monies, even though I served a bunch of cheap sushi. Okay, we actually made 300. We had less money to start than I thought we did. Let me close this. Okay, so, things to do in the game right now. Maybe I'll finish that Cleone quest? But we gotta go catch that one big one. Oh no, what's Otto wanna do? Hello, Dave. Have a good night's sleep.
Work it all.
Yes. Did you spend enough time talking to Sammy yesterday? I need to turn this microphone a little bit. There we go. Of course. We had not seen each other for so long before yesterday, so we definitely had a good time. By the way, I want to show you something. Come to the farm if you have time. And by that, he means come now. Is Sammy gonna start raising chickens for us? Are we gonna start serving chicken sashimi? Chickens? And, Sammy, what happened to your clothes?
Get out.
Hey, yo, I talked to my pops yesterday and got all sentimental, you know what I'm saying? How long did it take me to edit the shirt on my model? About an hour. I unfortunately forgot how to make custom shirts in V-Roy Studio, so there was a little bit of faffing around, being like, wait, do I click this? Do I click that? Which part do I use? And then eventually I had to look up a YouTube video about it. And it was easy. Looks nice, thanks. It's, hang on. Let me get rid of the Tate Bro crab. So he's not in the way. So, it's supposed to be this shirt from Splatoon 3. I don't think I did a perfect job, obviously, but it's good enough. It's close enough that if you were a real Splatoon weirdo, you would recognize it. But yeah, it's like technically, even if the weather won't make up its mind, it's spring now, so I probably shouldn't be wearing a hoodie all the time. But enough justification. Let's see what Sammy's got to do with chickens. I became a rapper because I love music, but I got tired of that celeb life. Hey, Reuben.
Yeah.
I think we could use them to cook with. I'll give them to you when you get here. Take them to the cook. So, you quit music?
Yeah.
No. I will stay here to enjoy my rural life and nature while writing new songs, yeah.
Yeah.
I can release new songs at any time online these days. It's so easy to do that. Aha. By the way, what's up with that chicken? Heh, I shared some food with the neighbors and they gave me this chicken in return. I wanted to make a yummy fried chicken. My son wanted to let it lay eggs. Okay, everyone, buckle up. We're gonna learn about chicken math, where raising one chicken costs almost exactly the same as raising two chickens. And so you're like, well, maybe I could have three chickens then. And then you get way too many chickens and you have more eggs than anyone knows what to do with. And he made a chicken farm overnight. He reminds me of my younger self. Haha, and I got inspiration from the rhythm of the hammer, you know? It warms my heart to see you and your son together. Speaking of the chicken, from now on, I will offer you eggs at my farm. Oh, eggs, you say? I can't give you more than one egg because there is only one chicken on the farm. If you want more chickens, ask Sammy. Exactly. We got it. It's super cheap. Once you have one chicken, just might as well have two. Remember, only one egg per chicken a day, no more. That is not how chickens work. I think some people would prefer chickens work that way, but that is not how chickens work.
Yeah.
There are two grades for eggs, grade A and grade B. Good grade chickens lay good grade eggs.
Yeah.
I will stay here with my pops. Come visit me often, yo.
Work it off.
Eggs, huh? Pancho's menu will be expanded for sure. You can now raise chickens. You can acquire eggs in the morning. Try developing new recipes. Got some rice. The slang, sad. Oh, I just hit my microphone. Now what's wrong with the slang? It's not even that bad. He's just going with yo. Shop? Oh, he can sell me growth fertilizer. Pest fertilizer. Harvest up fertilizer. Nutrient compost. It looks like these eggplants died. That's a shame. May as well buy more vegetables, right? Carrot, 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 eggplant, eggplant, eggplant. What's it gonna take to get more more chickens?
Huh.
Dad has never scolded me.
Yeah.
He told me to do whatever I want. The only problem is that he goes on and on. Some expensive chickens. Ruben dislikes every slang. That can't be true. You exist on the internet. I mean, it costs the same to buy a white chicken as a brown chicken. Of course I'm gonna buy this one. Oh, but this one might not produce any eggs. I see. So if I want guaranteed eggs, you want the white chickens. Modern slang is like 90% of the words people use on the internet. The fact that I use the word like as a verbal comma was very despised as slang back in the 1990s, and now it's just normal. I'm gonna get the brown chicken. There, now I got two chickens. I guess we'll check the fish farm to see if anything's interesting growing there. Okay, so our starry puffer population's going up. That's good. Let's send some of these sugarfish to the kitchen. Should probably just sell the lionfish. They don't... Nah, we'll send her to the kitchen. Then most of these to the kitchen. What we really want to breed are the starry puffer fish. And I guess we'll leave the blue tangs alone. They're a good filler. Sometimes it's good to just put cheap, tasty food on your menu. They still got room to grow. Got two fangtooths. So that means these can keep breeding. Everything else is just kinda meh, it's here. Looks like Otto has more things. How was my day? I didn't do a whole lot after the stream yesterday. I mean, I made this shirt. That was basically it. I need to check Kurage Bunch. I didn't check them if they have new comics this week. See, I can make... We can open up Glacial Passage stuff. Sorta might as well, right? It is orange. It is a very orange shirt. I forgot how to make custom shirts in Vroid, and I just kind of spent a while clicking on random things until I eventually gave up and was like, fine, I'll watch a YouTube video about it. And then the YouTube video took about 30 seconds for me to be like, oh yeah, I click on that button. Right, I'm dumb. Anyway, I'm going to try to finish that Cleone quest. Because I kind of want to fight the giant Cleone. Is there a shark meat event coming up? Does that mean we're going to have tons of sharks to deal with? I don't want to go where there are sharks. Let's see, auger. Sea auger. Shock harpoon. I don't like that. Minigame. You are not dumb. You are not smart. Very average. Grew up in a place where very average was exceptional. messed up my whole perspective on a lot of things. Have I caught these little pink fish? Sea Goldie. Well, might as well catch the other ones. Now they don't have to be alone. Their little school is safe in my bag. Uh-oh. I just heard something suspicious. Ruben had an English and a math test today. Well, I hope you did well in the English. Math, I can't help much with. I can do basic geometry and algebra, and that's basically it at this point in my life. Hey, it's another shrimp. Come here, you. Let's see, hush tart? Nope. Hush tart does not stop the sharks, and there are lots of sharks now because of the shark event coming up. Catching you to stop you from hurting me. These guys make good sushi, right? Like, they're part of my fancy plate we made for Michael Bang, I think. I really should focus on getting down to the... Ooh, bones. But I should focus on getting down to the deep sea area. And not fighting that shark right there. Barracuda, you're not good food anymore, but... You can make filler on my menu. Wait, what are these? Is that like a legit anchovy? Bluehead tilefish. Well, that was quite a descent for it just to be a dead end. Oh well. Let's see, we're barely burdened, so we'll be fine. There's an OT refill. So let's kill this barracuda real quick. And then I guess catch this giant trevally, because we need his fins to upgrade our gun. Oh, I just killed him. We didn't actually catch him. Gun enhancement kit. Underwater rifle 2, level 2. Now if that giant Cleone is hostile, we should be safe. We should not have much to worry about. There's a shrimp over here in these spikes. I want to catch it. Black tiger shrimp. Very tasty. Ooh, all done. Should I go back up now? That grilled shark is going to eat me while the cutscene's happening. Or never mind, the giant Cleone's gonna eat me. Yeah, well, it was hostile. I don't know that their mouths work like that. What is this place? Like, I don't really know where the mouth is in this thing. It's been a while since I really knew what animal class it belonged to. It's probably a type of sea slug. Cleone Queen! I'm done. I probably won't get away without a fight. Whatever, let's defeat it first. It has projectiles. They are poison. Does that mean it's dead or just mad? Not afford that miss. Okay, I could afford that miss. Ooh, what a monster. It still stings. Let me see if there's anything useful to pick up. Is there anything useful for me to pick up to, like, not die right here? Oxygen? I mean, that looks like a thing. Got a giant Cleone Queen tentacle. Now we can pick up the shiny thing. Hey, Reuben, welcome back. I see something shiny over there. I should have a look. I should take apart this gun. You did not hear what I said. I don't think I've said anything useful since I fought that, or since the beginning of that fight with the, giant Cleone Queen. Hey, it's a photo of that girl with the puppet. I'll have to take it back up. About the tests? Oh, I was just hoping that you did well on your English test. Dang. Missed. Again. Only one bullet left. And we got him. Yay. I'll use a submersible for this one. I'm pretty sure they taste terrible, but maybe we can upgrade them to be better. Reuben felt like it went well, so he probably has a 4. I hope he did better than a 4. Let's see. These are food, right? Fast. You don't like your English teacher? You only have a couple months left with them, so I'm sure you can make it through. Let's see, there's that little jerk. I need rocks to kill him easily. Oh, there's a rock. I see a rock here. You are correct, just give me the points. You gotta spell the Dutch words and the English words correctly, Reuben. You did. Okay then. I can't argue with that then. Let's see, there's that missing child somewhere around here. Ooh, bombs. Let's not use the bombs. Let's catch this guy. He still has a bounty on the eco app. I'm pretty sure this one has a bounty on the eco app. Yeah. Wow. Four more. Basically starting from level one on those. See, O2 tank. Probably more useful than our used up scooter. Anyway, there's always a writing question, and Ruben's just blogging. No. It's all gonna be K. We're gonna get our amethyst. Crouch. Pickaxe, and might as well grab it. Let's just try not to do anything too stupid. There's all these different seahorses. There were some words we probably did not have to learn. You gotta learn all the words. That's just how it works. Because they're gonna keep making up more. Okay, so this is where we met Rama, or whatever her name is. Ramo? Ramo. Scooter would be nice, but kinda gotta carry what we got. Maybe we'll find that missing child. And if we don't, well, at least we're populating our deep sea fish farm. The words aren't in the English Bible, if you use a logic that a atlas the Bible of AK is. What? Wait, what's that? A jellyfish fragment. Maybe it's left over from that seaweed collector's... What, the seaweed collector's turtle ate? Let's follow it. Following a jellyfish fragment, what? I'm not sure what we're doing here. Oops. They were probably in the other book. I'll take this. Oh, there he is. You just hang. Oh, God. Preemptive violence. Math is really difficult. I had more of a problem with arithmetic than with math. It's like math is mostly just logic and learning little tricks that help you skip logic. This must be the seaweed collector's house. Why am I here again? I hear something from inside. Should I open the door and go inside? Some kids even skipped full pages. Oh no. No, please help me. Donna might have eaten something weird. She's gone crazy. She's been gobbling up the jellyfish. Something's wrong with her. Duh, a human?
Whoa.
I guess now is not the time to judge. Please help! What do? I'll have to catch her and try calming her down. I can't use my guns? Can I do anything with this net? This pot. Nope. I can go hide underneath this bench. Ruben skipped one question and had to put some random numbers somewhere else. Well, I don't think random numbers are gonna win, like, they're gonna get you anywhere, but. Okay, interesting. They get some points. Oh! She was mad because she had a plastic bag in her throat. It's a plastic bag. Who would throw something like this into the sea? Lots of people. Lots of people would do that. Dave, unfortunately. There was a question that was suspiciously difficult. I probably wouldn't understand it if you tried to explain it to me. Suspiciously easy. Like, suspiciously difficult in that it was easy. You subverted my expectations. Good job. Thank you, human. Now I'll be able to gather seaweed with Donna again. Whew, what a relief. Almost choked by a plastic bag? That was a close call. Anyways... Make sure to relay this message to the humans. Tell them not to throw such things into the sea. Yeah, humans, stop throwing your trash in the sea. Fishing to make a living is understandable. However, I don't understand why they need to throw away such things. If they throw away such horrendous things again, I'll give them a taste of my half-moon kick. Is Dave gonna learn to flash kick? The question was about circles, I guess? I can do some circle math. Well, it looks like everything's taken care of. Like the very basics of circle math. Finding area, circumference, stuff like that. I can't... figure out the measure of a tangent based on, like, angles anymore. Whatever. Looks like to visit Meemaw's restaurant later. The radius of a circle is also its height, right? The radius is halfway across a circle. So the diameter is the full length from one side of a circle to the other, and the radius is half of that. And then the circumference is just the way, how far it is to go all the way around the outside of the circle. Yay, math. In Japanese, I know Choki, I think that's radius, and Shucho, I think that's circumference. And I don't know how to say either of those words in Spanish. And I should probably just escape now. We're overburdened. We did a good thing. We saved the people. Yeah, so for a half circle, which we got. Ruben didn't know how to say them in German. Probably sounds like how you say them in Dutch. We will hang on to... I mean, we're going to the... We're going to the Sea People house right now, so may as well. Huh? You're new. We're still introducing characters. Clara. She a pearl diver? What's going on? You're riding a raft. My name is Clara. I didn't expect to see a person on the sea in this storm. Have you seen a great white shark around here, young one? Nope. I've seen many sharks, but no great white. That can't be true. Klaus, the enemy of my husband, must be around somewhere. All traces lead to this place for sure. Klaus is known to be sighted only on stormy nights. On a stormy night just like this, it took my husband. It was 36 years ago. It will appear here for sure. Everything leads me to this place. By the way, I've dived several times and noticed that the terrain changes every time. Oh, you're not mistaken. The sea around here is very confusing for newcomers. Gosh, I just don't have enough time to get used to it. Young one, can you find Klaus for me? I'd rather not. Oh, me? Yes, you. You are familiar with this place. I need to find it before the storm passes. Just locate it, and I'll take care of the rest. Help this old lady, please. I know I'm going to regret taking her for her word here, but if all I have to do is find it, it's okay. I can do that. She looks desperate. Okay. All I have to do is just find it. Alright, I'll sweep the area. Oh, really? Thank you, young one. Just give me a holler when you find Klaus's hideout, and I will come right to you. So, that's a tonight thing, right? Not a right now thing. Yeah, find the vortex. Meemaw. Oh ho ho, thanks to you, Dave, I'm able to open the restaurant again. It looks good. I don't want to call this repayment of debt, but I was thinking of making food that humans can eat. Really, Meemaw? Hey, I'm a better cook than any other sea person. I'm sure my food will surprise even humans. Oh, I do need to experiment. Ho ho ho. I'll tell you when it's ready. Look forward to it. Alright, now we need to go find that, farmer and tell him we made some fancy seaweed food. Mima looks a bit like Ruben's German teacher. Yeah, she's certainly a type of person you see pretty much anywhere. See, this guy should be able to make... except with normal skin. Are you saying the German teacher has normal skin, or Mima has normal skin? Workshop. You can make steel ropes, ice diamonds, opal tubes. I see. And I can sell him ore. Oh, he'll buy glass and fragments. I'm not sure whether I should sell things to him or sell things to Cobra, really. Mima's the one with normal skin. That's interesting. Here, this is cuisine made from seaweed. What are these little round white balls? Human cuisine. I can predict the taste, but I'll give it a try. Yeah, I saw that, Ruben. The bomb jump into the star. Good work. Ah, this is a new taste. The soft texture of seaweed, the little white grains, they go so well together. This yellow thing, it adds such rich flavor. They're sea urchin eggs. Is this your first time seeing them?
Yeah.
Sea urchins? That spiky creature? Humans eat that kind of stuff? We eat their gonads. That seems to be the only part of them that's edible. I guess humans are able to use various sea ingredients. I'm surprised. Haha, Boncho is very serious about seafood. Alright, a promise is a promise. I'll open up the seaweed farm for you. Oh! You would almost think that Ruben was... that he mains soldier or demo. Yeah, keep doing those bomb jumps, just don't do them in real life. However, I have to make a separate farm to avoid food supply issues to the village. It's gonna take some time, please wait. Okay, I'll be back later. This is exciting. All that for 35 bay. Let's drop off some seahorses in case I ever care to engage with that minigame again. Ooh, the sea dragon's fast. Shocker, seahorse is not. Alright, so what else can I do? I could go to the glacial passage and collect more fish for my fish farm. With music, not with school. We were in the classroom with the first two grades. Got some memories out of that. First two grades, like little kids? Like really little kids? Yeah, tiny humans. See if I can catch anything good in here. Like, these guys didn't make good sushi, and the barrel eyes didn't make good sushi. I probably didn't give the, vampire squid enough of a chance. What is that? There's some little shrimp I could catch. White shrimp. There's a little shrimp over here somewhere. Ah, there he is. Hey, it's a blobfish. Let's not make blobfish sushi. Okay. Want to get a picture of the mural. Camera was not focused. Okay. Squid caught. I figured I would shoot him with a gun and maybe that would make this a little faster, but the fact that I have to switch up. It's easier just to hit them repeatedly with the harpoon. Ooh, we got a vampire squid tentacle. So there's no other way out here. We can't go down deeper. I don't want to kill the blobfish. Is there anything over here? This is where the monsters are, isn't it? Kind of hard to escape from here if anything bad happens. I don't remember this. I guess it got kind of smashed up by the, by that zombie waking up. Sadly, while the classroom is smaller since the new school, and they don't have water sink anymore, or the paint things, or a lot of space. I remember that on a day when the higher grades went to gym, we would go to their classroom because they had a digital board, and we would watch Malfel and Herche. Is that French? Or is that Dutch? Behold my ignorance. I mean, I could catch this squid. I think it's a Dumbo squid, right? Dumbo octopus. Mofel and Pierce are names. Yeah, but what language are those names, like what country are those names from? They are Dutch. Okay. Have we just... Are the zombies gone? Did the one giant zombie rampaging about manage to clear the passage of smaller zombies? I've only got to catch two more things down here. And then my eco research... research, air quotes, will be done. One more. Oh, I could just catch the blobfish and be done. I'm lazy. I'll do it. You want to go to the promised land at the surface? Don't you want to see the light of the sun, Mr. Blobfish? Let's see, so this is all broken. Ah, this is where I was just a moment ago, right? Yeah. It just, now it's all broke. Yeah, okay. I don't like that slamming noise. Okay, so we've completed some research. We've looked around in the glacial passage. We did not find the beluga whale. Who's just vibing? Our new pet blobfish, who we're totally not going to give to Boncho for food. Okay, we didn't check this area. Maybe he's in here. glowing. You know, dude. There are still zombies. It looks like this one, all he's guarding is like that one golden totem. So we could get the golden totem if we really wanted it. Save the blobfish. And we're fine. Is there a passage up here now? I think this is where we came in. This section seems fairly undamaged. And all we're gonna get from doing this is a golden statue, aren't we? Got some grades back? Like for your tests from yesterday? Got a minus for bio. I think I'm just gonna go back. You know what, if the beluga's past that zombie, sorry, beluga, you're on your own. And a 7.6 for NASK, sodium, sulfur, potassium. Two of those explode, and one of them burns. Science. Yeah, don't put sodium, potassium, and sulfur in the same area. That might not turn out well. I mean, it would burn a lot. Okay, so we could go take a little trip to the glacial area. Just a short one. NASK is science. I mean, because we're not full on our inventory yet, so we could just, you know, catch a couple more little things out here. Wait, what? Why is Wang here? Oh, right, because he's looking up to the narwhal. Human, your clothes look very warm. Why don't you go inside and take a look? You are weaker than you look. It's a gun upgrade kit. Eh, poison harpoon. Sure. We'll take the poison harpoon. Just don't think too hard about it. These guys look tasty. If I can catch them. We can smash this snow crab. Don't people love snow crab? That they'll get into like fights and buffets over it? Set a little bait here. Well, we can sort of free the blobfish. How was my food? I had canned chili for lunch today. It was how it always is. We're gonna use the blobfish for bait. He's gonna make friends with a crab of some sort. Sesame seeds. Perfectly preserved at the bottom of the ocean. In an icy container. Wait, what? What do I do? I didn't see what my quick time event was. Oh, it died. Yeah, let's just go for the enhanced harpoon. For lunch, Reuben had one rosin ball. Is that like a fruit and something in it? Yep. Our blobfish made a crab friend. Let's go bring him up. And then we'll stop catching fish so we don't get overburdened when we find the narwhal. Not narwhal, beluga whale. We got two snow crabs, a horsehair crab, and another snow crab. So good job, blobfish. You got us lots of crab. Let's go find that beluga. The rosin ball was not much, or the getting crabs was not much. We've got all this turmeric. Rosin ball was not much. I mean, one ball of anything doesn't sound like a lot of food. Oh no, beluga! Why does he look like he's breathing? He's underwater. He can't breathe the water. Oh, a beluga. Why is it here? Is this your doing, octopus? An Antarctic octopus? It's venomous. Maybe poisoned? I'm gonna shoot that octopus. Why, you little... I'm not letting you go. Stop there! Okay, I don't think I'm allowed to shoot it. Aha, you can't get past that currency either, can you? I cornered this one. Looks kind of pitiful up close. No, I can't be weak now. I will show it who's boss. No, I'm gonna rescue it. It can be friends. It's a dumb animal. It doesn't know why it poisoned our beluga. So the Rosinball is a ball with dried grapes. It's like one liter. That's a very large ball of grapes. What is this bottle? The octopus dropped it. Antidote, perhaps. I should go back to the beluga. Why would the octopus have an antidote to its own venom? It's a smart animal, but it's like, does it even understand the fact that it is poisonous? I don't know. I don't think so. Curry blocks. Yum. Frozen cod. Nope. It's not that large. It's smaller than my cheese sandwiches, but still good food. I keep hitting my microphone. I hope no one hears that. When I started teaching in August, I started, like, instead of bringing peanut butter sandwiches like I normally would eat at a job, I brought cheese sandwiches instead. And they really grew on me. Like, that's now sort of a normal thing I eat, is, just cold cheese on bread. It's food. Only one isn't good, though. Cheese and bread. It's Dutch food, it's British. I think people in Britain eat just plain cheese sandwiches. In America, usually you'd, like, grill the sandwich, but you don't need to do that. You don't look well. Do you want to try this? Here, drink this mysterious fluid I got from an octopus. Reuben ate them for like a whole year. Raisin balls? Oh, you look better now. I am relieved. Why don't you return to the village? You can get there alone, right? Could you just give me a ride back to the village, Beluga? I would appreciate it. No? Nuh-uh. He's gone. Cheese sandwiches. Ate them for like a whole year. Yeah. Very doable. They're a pretty good lunch. Mission complete. Find the Beluga. But we are almost overburdened. And we got crabs and all kinds of stuff that I want to get back to the sushi place. Bread. Butter, cheese, bread. I haven't tried it with butter. Maybe I'll do that later. That's why we chased the octopus, so there's not gonna be a pickaxe over there. Somewhere appears the exit. I think. Pretty sure. That's the scary thing about diving under ice, is you never know if you'll find the exit again. Is this the control panel we already went to? First glacial cave. Yeah, this is probably the control panel we already did. California spiny lobster. Isa Ebi. They are expensive food. That's a bomb. We've gotten in trouble using bombs before. ice harpoon. Cool idea, but no thanks. Alright, so how do we get out of here? I could have sworn we just swim up somewhere. Did I swim by it and not notice? Like, we entered close to this rock. It was somewhere around here. Oh, there we go, there's the hole. Found it. Ruben started eating chia sandwiches because of his technology teacher. Your technology teacher probably started eating chia sandwiches because so many kids are allergic to peanut butter. That's my reason. Okay, so finding the beluga didn't really do anything for us, but... Oops. Let's go back to the boats. They are? Yeah, lots of kids are allergic to peanuts. It's one of the most common food allergies. And it's also one of the common food allergies that can kill people. Hey, we got snow crab roe and horsehair crab roe. We're gonna eat, like, luxury. Peanut butter ain't popular here. Yeah, it's kind of an American thing, isn't it? It looks kind of gross if you're not used to it. Which is something that didn't cross my mind at all until someone mentioned that it looks kind of like poop. I was a man before I ever considered the idea that peanut butter might not look like food. Anyway, so do we try to find the vortex or we try to help Maki? Ruben doesn't know what is popular. Yeah, I mean, kind of the same here. It's sort of secondhand knowledge. What is popular? What do other people like? Because what do I like is not going to be popular. Anyway, let me take a minute to go grab more water and go pee. And I'll be back, and then we'll serve some sushi to that Cleon-obsessed little girl. And do other stuff. Anyone who's lurking, headphone warning, here we go. Alright, I'm back. Let me scoot this down here. So we got... Okay. And back to the game. So, we could help Revenge, or we could go give a little girl a pet Cleone. Hello, Electron. You're just in time for us to, I don't know, inspire some child to keep living with her new tiny deep sea slug pets. Here, a Cleone, like you asked. It's so beautiful. Thank you, Dave. And I found this. It's a picture of you from the bottom of the ocean. Is this a photo of me? Yeah, that's Reuben. There was a huge Cleone. I found this in its home. There's a button on the back. I'll try pressing it. Oh, dramatic story time. Hopefully the audio for this doesn't get my YouTube video copyright claimed. Maki, it's your father. If you're watching this, then I've probably failed my expedition. I couldn't really take care of you with my busy schedule. My greed for more work has turned me into an irresponsible father. You haven't been able to make many friends because we kept moving around because of my work. Yeah, Electron, I did get a new outfit. It's a copy of a Splatoon 3 shirt that I really liked, and I just finally decided, hey, it's springtime. I should probably not be wearing a hoodie all the time anymore. Even so, I want you to forgive me for being a terrible father and live a confident life. Reuben sits outside, away from the AULA culture, so he does not know what popular is. I'll keep watching you from afar, so don't ever lose your smile. Static. Reuben's wearing a hoodie. Well, I mean, I'm on camera, so I should try to make my costume interesting sometimes. Anyway, it seems to cut off. Oh no, we broke Maki. Don't be too upset. It seems your father really loved you, Maki. Yeah, don't worry, he's just dead. Please let me work here. What? So suddenly? Yes, my father wouldn't like to see me so lethargic and sad. I want to show him that I'm doing fine and working hard. So go to school, Maki. And as you've shown concern for me and helped me, I'd like to help you as well. Bancho, what do you think? What a spirited child. I like her. You can start working here today, but you won't be getting any special treatment. We don't have any more employee slots, though. Yes, okay. I'll work hard to learn and become an amazing chef. We have hired a child. VIPing Wong Pong, the mystery chef? Child labor. Yeah. We don't have to pay them as much because reasons. Hello, everyone. This is Yui from NDC Station. Today, I present a new program called Challenge the Chef, featuring Vincent Yamaoka. It's been a long time, everyone. I am Vincent Yamaoka. The champion from the last season was Bancho, who was praised by Vincent. He will be the defending champion today. Defending champion. And this season's first challenger is Wong Pong. It's my honor to be here. I am Wong Pong from Hong Kong. Nice to meet you, Wong Pong. All right, we've met the contestants. Now, let us begin the show. This is kind of out of nowhere. You two will compete with dishes on the same day at the same place on a given theme. Vincent Yamaoka will judge your dishes. Today's theme for the contest is Chinese cuisine. Oh, wow. Seems like someone's got a little bit of an advantage there, maybe. Yeah. Oh, well, this isn't good. As you know, Chinese cuisine develops many different cooking styles in its long history, and also the fact that China is a gigantic country. You got kind of different foods in different corners of that place. When we start talking about Chinese cuisine, many will think of stir-fried meat and vegetables. But that's not all. There is more than that. This time, you two will compete for the dish using fish. Give me a Chinese-style fish dish. May the best chef win. I heard of you and your reputation, Boncho, but I will beat you with a fabulous recipe from Hong Kong. Wow, Wong Pong just issued an official challenge. This should be interesting. He forgot noodles. Yeah, noodles, bao, all kinds of soup. Though, I don't think it would be unfair to say that a lot of Chinese cooking does revolve around put things in a wok, cook them on really high heat for a short period of time. But I am no expert. Anyway, you know the rules, folks. We will be back in 2 days to broadcast the intense competition between the two contestants in real time. Stay tuned and see what transpires in tonight's Challenge the Chef. Okay, get out. We have a business to run here. Go, shoo. He just dropped into the restaurant without letting them know first. This challenge might not even be legal. It's just content. We're just content for their show. Are you okay? You're not familiar with Chinese cuisine, are you? I don't need to be Chinese to compete with him. I will use a Chinese culinary style, but with a type of fish they've never tasted before. Let's not go overboard, Boncho. No, we should go overboard. Let's feed them barrel eye fish. I can't teach them a lesson with an ordinary dish. If you say so. Bring me the ingredients I want in 2 days. Chinese cuisine is no problem. I will need stargazers, wheat, olive oil, and eggs. The wheat might be hard. We've already got stargazers, lots of those. Oh yeah, we need an egg, too. Let's see what we can do with those batfish. Name. Batfish. It wasn't called a batfish, was it? We got a lot of cuttlefish. We probably should upgrade them. The restaurant's not even open. I mean, they know that if the restaurant was open and we had people, customers who were serving, they wouldn't get 2 seconds of our time. We don't have 2 seconds. Really in diminishing returns territory here. 6 more monies for 20 more flavor, but it takes 22 cuttlefish. Whatever. That's why we got so many. The cuttlefish isn't what we're here for. We're here to find the bat fish. Because I caught a bunch. Ooh, we have a lot of giant trevally meat. Upgrade that. Grilled shark meat. Still doesn't taste good. Still doesn't taste good. 100's acceptable, but we'll wait. Bat fish. Barracudas, well, it tastes good now, just whatever. Parrot head fish. Haddock sushi. Doesn't taste very good, but it's expensive. We'll get that somewhere decent eventually. Harlequin hind. There we go. Long fin batfish. We got a bunch of them, and they do not sell for anything. This wasn't worth it. Megamouth shark. We could sell those. Like, this is acceptable. There, that'll be on our menu today. Megamouth shark. Let's put something expensive on the menu. What do I need for this? I need harlequin hinds. If I can just find these harlequin hinds, then... Okay, so the little blue fish with green stripes. I think I recognize those. If we can catch a bunch of these, then we can make a whole bunch of really expensive sushi. Really expensive sushi. What's this? Sea Goldie. No, we're not serving that. See, frilled shark is not very good tasting. If you lose or decline your repatriation, you go down, so they force you. What? Are you saying they're gonna threaten that chef to send him to mainland China instead of Hong Kong? Let's see, trevally. We get 5 servings for this. I'll put 10 of those on the menu. Purple sea urchin sushi. I've collected a lot less of those than I thought I did. Moray eel curry. Could use this to get rid of some of that turmeric. I can only make 3 servings, though. We're making a really weird menu tonight. Arctic cod is only level 1. It's already that expensive, but not very good tasting. We'll just have to keep catching them. Crab sushi. Golden king crab. Doesn't taste very good, but it's very expensive. We'll think about that later. Antarctic octopus. Tastes terrible. Blobfish sushi. Also tastes terrible. Telescope fish. Very expensive. Snow crab sushi. We got enough of these, we can enhance a little bit. It'll get to an acceptable point. I might just want to put these bluefin on the menu tonight. Comb jelly. I thought we had more of these than that. Dumbos, octopus, nah. Seasoned kaji med. Sound great. You know what? No, let's go with something cheap. Let's just do a normal. Oh, what got this? Oh, right, we caught a bunch of these dudes. Like, a lot of them. because they're easy to catch, and there's a lot of them. Sure, y'all go on the menu tonight. That should be enough food for everyone. Staff. So... we could train her. All she's got is cooking. That is all she can do is cook. But she might turn into an okay cook. If she's gonna live here, we may as well make her a better cook. Cooking ability increases permanently. What do you mean permanently? I think everyone else is like level 5. Okay, so she can cook like crazy if we hire her as our chef. She learned small spotted dart Kajime soup. So she's at 300. Raul gets us extra ingredients, and I never see Caroline actually refill this wasabi. Okay, we're putting a child we just hired on the line tonight. That's your job. You're here now. We look forward to working with you, Maki. Everyone else can get trained to level 6 tomorrow. Why don't we research some food? Rock lobster. Lobster roll. Stellet puffer nikogori. Auger and pufferfish skin. Mixed and hardened. Oh, that's expensive. Where are we gonna get more tentacles of Cleone Queen, though? It could be a temporary item. It could be one of those things that someone eats one time and is like, wow, this is amazing. And then they come back and they can never find it again. Ever. Ever. Small spotted dart Kajima soup. May as well learn Maki's recipe. Okay, so our menu's all good. Everything's tasty. Let's hope that our new chef does her job well. God, she looks so nervous. Deal with the plates, since I'm still the only one who can do that. Oh no. Any plates? Nope. We're gonna wasabi. All right. How'd we do? I saw one person get pissed off and leave. Made about as much money as yesterday. It's not great. I guess I could have gone for a night dive and helped that lady. I have to enter the cave with an outflowing current to turn on the second control room switch. Is there any way to enter the cave? The current may be weaker today. I should go check. Maybe the beluga will help me. We gotta go check on the farm, though.
Don't do it.
What do you think? Neat, right? And we got an egg. One egg. See, that was a carrot, right? I mean, I could probably buy more fertilizer to get more rice. Accelerates plant growth. Increases the yield. Well, hopefully that works. And let's check the fish farm. Oh, we got all these different types of fish to check on now. Okay, so batfish, just they're not going to sell for anything good. So we might as well just get rid of them. Sea Goldie also probably aren't going to be worth much. We want Starry Pufferfish, we want Titan Triggerfish. We need to find those little blue and green guys so we can harvest them. We also got a bunch of Blue Tang. May as well send a bunch to the kitchen as filler. If we can't figure out anything to put on the menu, we can put them on the menu. Just get rid of him. Okay, we need these coral trouts. Maybe we'll hang on to the barracuda. So we're not selling those, we're sending them to the kitchen. They're still overpopulated. We don't do anything with the big-eyed scad, so let's just get rid of them. Same thing with a narrow-barreled Spanish mackerel. Alright, now we're good. Okay, darkness fish. I guess we can send some chambered nautiluses to the kitchen. And some fangtooths. Maybe we can make some food out of them. Glacial fish. What do we got? horsehair crab. We're gonna keep these so they can breed. Cod has some potential. Kaplan's, ooh, one narwhal. Just got one of a lot of things. Gelatinous snailfish, I'm not selling that to people. Same with the eel pouts. Ice fish also didn't seem that good sushi-wise. Haddock though? Maybe. Arctic octopus? Maybe. We'll just leave these for now. Okay, so I guess we go to the glacial area? Like, there's an event with sharks. We also need to find wheat. I probably should have grown wheat. We had an opportunity to grow wheat and everything. We're not going to grow wheat in 2 days, though. Or are we? Why am I doing this? Expand rice paddy, expand field, level 2. They'll expand it by tomorrow morning. That's not soon enough. Can we just buy wheat from him? We can buy wheat seeds. Oh, we can buy wheat. We'll buy 2. Okay. Problem solved. Problem solved. Let's go fishing. Actually, it's not so much go fishing as let's go to the glacial area. I still can't upgrade my gun, right? I need those trevally fins, and I need more amethyst ore. Our aquatic thingy. We got a couple things we can turn in here. Investigate ecology. Still need to find sea grapes. Still need to find more pink seashells and orange starfish. Brooke Cooksta, Ruben's back, welcome back. You can see plastics floating in the water sometimes. It's bad for marine life, so be careful. Cobra, a beluga showed up in front of Boncho Sushi. Even a beluga knows that Boncho Sushi is a must visit, haha. MC Sammy, vegetable sushi, made by Mr. Boncho. Yo, I can feel the soul put into it. The farm now didn't have anything for us to really know about. Okay, let's go to the glacial area and see if we can solve some puzzles or something. I guess we'll catch these trout, since I sort of want to develop their sushi. Catch all of y'all eventually. missed much sea people action? No, we just managed our farm and our fish farm a little bit while you were gone. Oh no, it's a narwhal. Hey. Ha ha. And now we gotta go back to Sea People Village. That will refill our oxygen. We'll be okay. You know what? If you die in the water, you'll only be able to retrieve one item. Mima has something to tell us. She looks busy again. Long time no see, Dave. We got another, Achievo. Dumplings in the water for reopening her business. Deadly fish, except it's a narwhal. It's a marine mammal. How's it even living down there under the ice? I don't know. I wanted to tell you that I am back in the restaurant business, but couldn't find your number. Ha ha. Y'all have cell phones? The famous local dish of the village, Mima's seaweed dumplings. The dumpling skin is tight enough to maintain its form, even in the water. You should try some. Mm. How am I supposed to eat it underwater? Haha, why don't you try one now? I will make you a special version. I'm always down for delicious food. Increases the damage of the harpoon gun. Ah, yes, Matrix. Matrix references. How very timely. It's like math magic. Oh, it's really delicious. I feel like I'm energized. Oh, it's not just a feeling, it actually energizes you. Each dumpling contains different stuffing, so take your pick. Oh, the effect of seaweed dumplings dissipates when you leave the water, so visit me sometime when you need the effect. See you around, Dave. They can be ordered twice a day, once in the morning, once in the afternoon. Dumplings give you a special effect, but last until you leave the water. See what the effect is on the pause screen. So, we're paused. I don't see my Mima effects. See this right here, it says harpoon damage up basically. I'm slowly starting to amass a decent pile of bay. Why am I going over here? I don't really care. Oh, right. It's not the gambling place, it's the farmer. He can farm me seaweed now. Oh, human, the seaweed farm is ready. I see you got some seaweed seeds. Wanna try planting them? You can cultivate many kinds of seaweeds at Gumbo's farm. Seed breeding is available at Kazan's Seed Shop. Okay, how do I... Where did it go? What happened, Gumo? The manatee's baby. It just suddenly disappeared. Uh-oh, that's a big problem. The manatee's mom is also worried. Things are getting out of hand. Do you have any ideas? Maybe it saw the beluga and went to the glacial area? There is kind of a suspicious place. I'll go check it out. Maybe the baby's in the library. Maybe. Oh, thank you, human. I will be waiting. Lost baby manatee. Yeah, but how do I seaweed farm? Oh, in the seed shop, they're like, yeah, we'll sell you more seeds, buddy. I am glad you cleared the path to the glacial area. I was able to get some seaweed seeds. Check these out, too. You can cultivate them at Gumo's farm. Black coral. Southern bull kelp. Buck bean. I mean, may as well plant them. And then we're gonna go back to the glacial area and hopefully don't get murdered by a narwhal. We've got a bunch of this already, so maybe we'll may as well get more. Okay, back to glacial area. Fan lobster. We're gonna catch this sea dragon and see if it is food. Why so many ads? Did you get one of those ones where it's like 5 minutes of ads? Boy, oh boy, do I hate that. They annoy you with ads so that you will pay to get rid of them. Was it in the library? I didn't check. It's almost certainly out here. These guys look like they have potential, food-wise. My knife can't harvest this? Ruma keeps getting the Godzilla versus King Kong. Ooh, ice gun. I'll try that. Do I want to disassemble my old gun? I'll leave it here just in case. Just in case the ice gun's no good. Oh, this crying sound is... I should go to where the crying sound is coming from. See, we found the baby. It's less of a crying sound and more of a moaning sound, but... it's okay. Golden King Crab. This thing has 24 bullets in it. Would the library guy be able to be married since he is the only priest for the entire sea people? I don't know. Maybe it's like Catholics and you can't get priesty. The priest can't get married either way. It's like part of their job. They're not allowed to get married. Sounds coming from here. Looks like the entrance was blocked after the baby went in. Maybe I can break it if I drop something heavy. Like these, right here. Hopefully the magic sinking ice doesn't, you know, kill the baby when we drop these on it. Oh, we need one more. Yeah, as a marine mammal, he's got the same problem that Dave does, in that he only has so much oxygen before he drowns. So, here we go. The priests are not allowed. The sea people priests, maybe they aren't allowed to get married. It would be a little awkward to preside over their own wedding. Right, let's go save this baby manatee. New region, but it's like this actually tiny little ice hollow. Do you think the ice gun's even gonna work in this icy water? They are Catholics. And Reuben suddenly, sadly, still gets history. I mean, Catholics not, Catholic priests not being able to marry, that's not history, that's still a thing. That's a tiny baby manatee. It looks scared. We need to calm it down with our ice gun! No. Oh, there he is. There you go. We Nintendogs now. Manatee Petting Games. Okay, it's calmed down a bit. Shall we head out? They don't follow their own rules in the past. Okay, yeah, that was a thing. We're gonna take the baby man. We gotta escort it. Fine, Narwhal! If I don't take care of that, the baby manatee won't come out. Okay, that doesn't do damage. It does make him very slow, though. Game? Whoa, we just get to restart. No biggie. shall we head out? Let me just carve this guy up. Let's see what other gun we could have had. Basic underwater rifle level 3. It's an old model and not that powerful. Oh, maybe he took some damage out of that. Ugh. Why? I think I'm gonna take that shark down to get out of here. Very, very hard for someone who's not used to using WASD and pressing all these different buttons at the same time. Come on! Okay, ice gun, stupid. We're not using ice gun. Okay, I guess we can leave now. At least the baby manatee didn't get hurt. Got any interesting facts? Do you know how to get back? Get safely back to the village. Okay, we can deal with that quest a little bit more when we get back out. Interesting facts. Frozen food was discovered by accident on Arctic fishing missions. There must be a second switch somewhere inside, but the strong current is blocking access. What should I do? Get beluga'd. Oh, the beluga. What are you doing here? It's dangerous here. Go back. And then Reuben just bounces up to hit the jump star and touch the beluga. Oh, you want me to ride on your back? The beluga can swim against this current. Oh boy, will it be okay? Belugas have a giant fat deposit in their skull right here. Called a melon that helps them focus their sonar blasts. It's squishy. In this cave, you can move around with the beluga. Press control to destroy obstacles. Why control? Can I grab the shrimp? Ah! The shrimp is like a healing item for him. This is kind of cool, and I like the music. We'd only take 3 hits. Right, and it can shoot in whatever direction it wants. I don't know if that's an obstacle I can shoot through. Homing jellies, fine. Ooh, that was some smooths. And that was not. That was definitely not. And we killed the beluga whale. Oops. Sorry, beluga. I'm gonna put... Oh, okay, we got checkpoints at least. Like, why couldn't it be the shift button? Oh, what is that? That is a very scary looking jellyfish. Is that a mommy jellyfish? Big mommy jellyfish? No. That's not how jellyfish work. If it's a jellyfish, it is probably both mommy and daddy. It has a glowing weak point. We can kill it. No, we didn't come to hunt small fish. It looks all riled up. I must first calm it down. I can't use weapons in this state. Calm it down by killing its babies. Okay, we are going to put a finger on the control button so that I can more easily use it. Okay, I thought I could just ram those, but clearly I can't. There's another shrimp, but it's over here. This is kind of hard. Okay, so don't ram the jellyfish. Explode on their own. That's not good. Also not good. Alright, what kind of poison ball is gonna shoot this time? Both kinds. Alright. That wasn't the worst thing I've done. Maybe. Maybe that was the hardest thing I've done in this game so far. Ooh, lucky me! It went away! Now we can go down here, and we can also pick up this tentacle, I guess. The back door is open. Let's go through that. Phantom jellyfish poison sack. Yeah, that's food. Phantom jellyfish meat. Oh, that must be the switch. Should I activate it? No, let's not. We came all this way, let's not, you know, hit the switch. Interesting. Just get the ancient machines going again. Thank you. So we have one more to go. I heard big machinery operating outside. And I guess that's an exit for us. A door is open there. Maybe it leads outside, or maybe it's just a hole. You know, we're inside of a giant ancient machine. This could be where they keep, you know, the spent nuclear fuel rods, for all we know. Oh, I feel a lot less heat than before. Maybe I can go down now. Well, we're almost filled in our inventory. Like, we got a lot of shark meat, and narwhal meat. Got a couple of those trout thingies. It's still morning though, right? This is our first dive of the day. May as well check the big open area. See if we can go down to where it used to be too hot. Salts. See, that's it. Stuff we can't harvest because it's too cold. Curry blocks. I don't think we have any curry sushi. Enhanced Hush Dart 1 level 3. Makes fish sleep after 4 seconds. But it won't kill sharks. And we're kind of worried about sharks, even now. Ooh. Holy moly! Are these ancient creatures? They must have been released from the melting glacial ice. I wonder if those are any use to Boncho for his sushi place. I will bring him some samples if I catch any of them. Wapita Fidelius, or whatever. But we are too deep. My oxygen is rapidly depleting. Ah, it's a Dunkleosteus! We don't want to fight that. It has armor. It is the largest armored fish. We know very little about it other than its head was gigantic, and it probably was one of the first things that holds, like, the orca, great white shark, megalodon niche. Donner dog, ich habe Deutsch und Niederland. I don't know what that means. I recognize Germany and the Netherlands. No, we're going to cook you. We got narwhal meat. We got Wapta Feldensis roe. I don't know this critter. Also, when are we gonna get narwhal, like a baby narwhal, to put in our tank? Thursday. Oh, so Donner dog. Dog is day, I guess. Like, Guten Tag, dog. Ich habe, I have. Oh. Maybe I should learn German, but probably not. Maybe it's time to upgrade my equipment. Yeah, maybe. I still can't afford the deeper diving suits. So we're gonna have to make some money tonight and then spend all that money on a better diving suit. Donner da heb ich Deutsch in Netherlands. Donderdog. Is that Dutch for on Thursday? I have German and Dutch. I can maybe sell some stuff. Like, what are these valued at? 300 gold? If I sell just one of these, I can upgrade my suit. And now I'm poor. Well, I will be in a second. Sorry, sushi shop. I spent all my money on a better dive suit. We are super broke now. Tropical rock lobster. We're probably not going to find that in the glacial area. There they are. And I missed. And I missed again. When they're up against a wall like that, I gotta hit them right at the edge of my range. And that's a little hard. You can always sell the other gold statues. Yeah, but what if they're used for something? I'm so falling into that trap. I'm like, but what if I need it later? Every one of those Arctic cods weighs 5 kilograms. They don't look that big, but I guess they are. But if I eat it later, for getting more money, exactly. Narwhal. That's a tough narwhal. There was an oxygen refill right up here. We're gonna be okay. I mean, I could just go back to the... I could go back to the Sea People Village too, but... it's a little faster just to go... boop. There, we're full again. It's all good. Could use more bullets, though. This is seaweed. Oh god! I have no more bullets. Okay, now we go back to the Sea People Village. Because that was not good. When will be the last dive? This will probably be the last dive for today. There are new seaweed seeds available. Or I can buy... I can buy power-ups from Mima. Increases movement speed. Reduces damage taken. Increases melee damage. Reduces damage and increases movement speed. That'll probably help. Can I go to the library before that? Sure, I'll make a quick trip. Swam. Need to extend a book. Someone's got a job for us. But it's not Niamo. The contraption built by our ancestors is difficult to operate. And it seems that something caused the contraption to malfunction. I know it's not right to get you involved in matters of ours, but please do help us. I'm trying to help. Earthquakes are not only your problem. Humans are suffering from them too. I will find out the cause. Thank you. May the blessings of King Long be with you. Okay, we said hi. Let's go see if we can catch some more animals. Or the, I mean, we don't have any bullets left, so we gotta find a refill on bullets before we can catch any more animals. Big animals. Norway lobster, we might find that here. That's the reason he visited the city every 3 weeks. To extend a book. What do we call that in English? Like, renew? I don't spend enough time at my local library, clearly. We are clearly a little bit faster. I'm gonna use one of these ice fish. bait or a crab trap. Yep, go to the library and go home. Careful. Try not to find any giant animals that will eat us. There's a refill on our bullets. Thank you. Go! I hear a voice. It's coming from inside the cave. How do I break through this thick ice? I have to pierce it through the middle with something pointy. Otherwise, it won't even crack. Wait, something pointy? Maybe a narwhal's horn? Should I try luring a narwhal into the wall? That's scary. I need to find a scooter before that's gonna be any sort of sense. Shovel? Or a bullet? Yeah, maybe a bullet will break it? Oh, we can find a net gun. It's a gun enhancement kit. Like a net gun, we can catch a bunch of those guys. I heard something big. There he is. Come here, jerk. Alright, this should be enough. Now I gotta do my best to avoid it. Totally smart. Dave, thinking outside the box is optional. Yeah, this is not Breath of the Wild. This is not Tears of the Kingdom. This is not a game where you come up with your own solutions to problems. And so you get weird, cartoony things like this. That was close. I broke through the ice wall. Now to find the source of the sounds. Let's go grab our crab first. I'd hate to die and not, you know, lose it or something. Look, we're just gonna grab the crabs. I don't have to think about it later. Anything else good over here? I think I need these starfish. Yeah, the ecological investigating people want me to catch those. So, there's one more. Probably good to top off our auction before we go into our spooky cave hole. Current is stronger than I thought. I see some obstacles too. I have to focus. Get out of here. Alright, that's going to hurt me. Well, I hit the spikes or I hit the big Ah, those things again. Okay, well, we got somewhere. And the voice is... some dude is trapped. Oh, Tsuchi, again. Oh, you're that human from before. What brings you here? I heard a sound coming from inside. Are you trapped? Yes, I came in here to get some new seaweed with Donna and got trapped here together. We've been living off seaweed up until now, but we just about reached our limits. You came to help us. Thank you. No, I think I'm trapped here too. You useless. Sure. We might be able to get out if you manage to break through this ice wall, but it's too thick. Donna would have been able to ram it, but Donna is in no shape to do so. Maybe we can hook a rope to the end and catapult Donna into the wall to break it? That's a terrible idea, Dave. Animal cruelty. 0 points. Sure, Donna's shell is rigid enough to break the wall, but how do we throw Donna? His question is how, not why, or that's awful, what's wrong with you? He's just like, how? Well, if we tie your clothes together... What? My clothes? It's the only way. Get naked. We playing Angry Birds now? Cold. It's too cold. Just hold on for a little longer. We can't escape if we do nothing. Send Donna here. I'll launch Donna into the wall. Yeah, this is pretty awful. Angry fish. It's a turtle, though. Angry birds. No. That wasn't great. Angry animals, in general. I mean, I guess it's a good thing that we're saving this guy and not just leaving him to die, but... We could be making more of a beeline towards the ending. Sea person, fish, turtle, something, human, mammal. Ah, no! We slammed its head into a rock! The animal cruelty is real. We're doing some permanent damage to the brains of this turtle. That turtle should not function. It might not after this. Yay, we're free, baby! Or maybe we're just gonna go into a different hole. That was a success. Good job, Donna. That's you. We can head out through that door. Can I collect all the seaweed, though? Whew, I feel much better now. Well, we'll go with you. Talk to me when you're ready. This shovel is not the best for harvesting seaweed. Why is he missing a tooth? Because he's old. See, people just might not have the best dental plans. Why, Grandma has all of her teeth, does she? I'm not sure she does. Are you ready to head out? I'm ready. Here we go. Oh, Reuben's grandma has all of her teeth. Are you sure about that? Are you sure they're not fake? What? What? And Dave just being fantastically graceful. She does. She was very religious. She was a very religious dentist. I guess if you're a dentist, you see so many bad teeth that you really decide to take care of your own. Ooh, you got us out of there safely. Thank you, human. Take this. It's money. Or a chisel of some sort. It's an ice pick. You can break thin ice with it. With this, you should be able to reach small areas blocked off by ice. Oh, I see. I'm sure it'll come in handy. Thanks, Tsuchi. Aha. See you later, human. And there's the money. See, we don't really have a lot of stuff in our inventory right yet. Hey, look, it's a bomb. Maybe we can use that to kill narwhals. Here's a gun. Enhancement kits. And I'm pretty sure this is the last door. You can take care of your teeth with dentist tools. I don't think a dentist is going to be using that metal pick thing on their own teeth. Ugh, just makes my skin crawl thinking about the metal pick. Swam, what are you doing here? Are you being actually useful for once? Well, I came all the way here as the heat under the glacial area has been reduced. I can't fully trust humans like you. So I, the hero of the sea people, who defeated the giant Gaddon, came here to activate the thing myself. But I need your help because the inside is quite a mess now. Oh yeah? How messy? You will see for yourself. I'm afraid to see for myself, honestly, but we're in about as good condition to go in there as we could be. I don't know what this is. This is not a Devonian animal I'm familiar with. I mean, it looks like an armored fish of some sort, but beyond that, I got nothing. Trepan something meats. Drapanaspis. Tranquilizer gas bomb launcher. Oh, I guess we should take it apart for scrap. Cool, let's go see what mess Swam doesn't want to deal with. Are you ready to enter? Yeah, sure. Let's press that last button. Oh! There are air bubbles. There is no water up there. This near the roots of the divine tree, they are sucking the ground heat. As the tree has mutated, it seems to have absorbed everything, leaving the soil around it completely dry. I need to open the inner waterway to fill it with water again. But I can't reach the contraption up there, as it is not in the water. Human, you go up there and activate the contraption on my signal. You want me to go up there? Of course, you can't go up there. Alright, wait a moment. Probably should leave the goggles on, Dave. Here, you can switch between Dave and Swam. Choose the character that fits the situation to clear the path. Tab swaps. I can press S to sit. I can tap S to do squats. Swam just swims so casually. Okay, that doesn't look terribly doable. Aw, I do a little duck walk. Checkpoint! Nice. Okay, I guess that Swam's gotta get through this little obstacle course here. Oh, just barely got through there. Cool. And then Dave presses this. And Swam gets a path forward. I guess Swam now has to make a path for Dave. This is kind of cool. Ruben has done lingo. Like, Duolingo? I kind of want to see what's over here. Alright, I should have gotten Dave to go forward first. Game over. Ah, whoops. Yes, the owl. The owl. Alright, have Dave go forward first. Swam can only take 3 hits, but at this point, same with Dave, basically. They had to take away our oxygen meter as health. Right, so they just let me crush him. Oops. But I guess I made a path for Swam. Now we get to do this mess. Go, 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 go. We made it. Ribbon's gonna go now. Have a good one. I will let you know if something happens in the library, or you can, you know, or you can watch the VOD later. That's probably what needed to happen there. I was just checking if that upper section of this is going upwards. It looks like it's gonna need to. Okay, so the laser will melt this ice. Yeah, I was supposed to have Dave stand on that. I was a little afraid they would, you know, pull a, like, oh, you think you're so clever, again, like they've done so many times in this game. I'm like, I'm gonna put him on the raising platform, because I know that's where he's gonna need to be. And then it raises it just enough that Dave dies. Leave Dave right here, just in case we need that laser. Also, now Swam could access parts of Dave's puzzle area, but let's not worry too much about that. Guess we need Dave with his fancy gloves to pull that loose. And for some reason, the laser chuck turned off. Oh, there is a lever here. There you are. Yeah, pull that lever. There's another lever down here. I will pull this one myself. Send me a signal when you're ready, human. Go. And we have raised the water level in the water temple, and I guess that shook those rocks loose. So good for us. Mission accomplished. Water began to flow from the top. Good. It looked like an important device, and is filling the place with water. You pulled it without knowing what it does? Yes. I trust my gut feeling, you know. The water is filling up. I must suit up. There seems to be a path inside. Let's go in there. Let's keep going down in the dark, scary, water-flooded hole. Because this is the place that humans are meant to go. Fortunately, this place is filled with water. The place is packed with divine tree branches. Is there something stimulating the tree? This level of growth is not normal. I need to enter the control room to figure out what's what. We must move to the inner... We move to the inner switch, human! Follow me! From this point, we control both simultaneously. Swam has the ability to open two worm paths and penetrate through sea currents by dashing. Help Dave reach a destination safely. Oh, wow. My keyboard can't handle that four buttons being pressed at the same time. This is actually kind of cool. We, Masahiro Sakurai now, controlling two characters at the same time. This feels like playing a keyboard. So we gotta press both at the same time. And now that one opens. I'm sure this has been done before in other games, but this is really cool. I'll have Dave pull this. I mean, this would be a lot easier with just two people, but it's kind of fun to play it with one person, one keyboard. Just don't make me fight anything like this. Okay, we have a problem in that my keyboard will not register all these buttons at the same time. So this is going to go a little slow. We are making progress. And I lost all that progress by trying to make Swamp pull. I was like, let's give Swamp a turn to pull the block. But yeah, my keyboard can't see me holding right control and left control and Q and up at the same time. So we just gotta go slow. Seems like a little bit of a oversight on the developer's part to be like, yeah, some keyboards don't see four buttons being pressed at the same time too well. I'm sure there's some gamer mode I can activate in Windows that would make it so this will work, but maybe it's an oversight, maybe it's not. Like, the fact that this is working somewhat, okay, so it would register me pressing to the side of Swam. So we're good. So what are we trying to do with these buttons? Press them all fast. I'm kind of scared. At least it's not quite as picky as it was on land with Dave, where if I just touch the sides of these when they're in the state of kill Dave, that Dave dies. Is there anything interesting at the top of this? Whoop. Seems like a no. Checkpoint. Huh, matching my rhythm underwater. Humans aren't as hopeless as they seem. Alright, let's proceed through the door ahead and flip the switch. Just drop the rock on both of their heads. I do not want to fight that, so we're gonna have to fight that, aren't we? Ugh, what is that creature? It's a creature that should have been extinct, like, over 200 million years ago. Look at that snout, it's scary. I have seen it before in an ancient creature codex. It's called a helicoprion, if my memory is correct. Didn't expect Dave to know about prehistoric sharks.
Let it go.
But it went extinct 200 million years ago. Yes! I got the number right. Maybe it's been trapped in ice and now has been released as the ice melts in this region. Well, whatever, it's lived for 200 million years frozen and now it's gonna die. It's got a buzzsaw. It's like, how does this type of tooth work? It's an archaeological mystery. And the solution is, it's a buzzsaw. I've been spotted. What should we do, Swam? 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 Swam is gone. Human, this place looks strategically important. Since this is an ancient deep sea creature, it won't sense bright light. I will hit a divine tree fruit here to blind it, and you lure the creature. Sounds like a reasonable tactic, but all you do is just hide, it seems. Anyways, that saw blade looks extremely dangerous. I should either hide somewhere or use the divine tree fruit as Swam suggested. Wrong button. Well, might have gotten to phase two. And it just immediately annihilates me. At least it's a little slow. That's it? Or phase three? Come on. Do we do it? Ha ha, freeze my strategical brain. It brought us victory. If you say so. Now, the monster is gone and we can access the door. Let's go in, human. No, I can't control Swam anymore. Investigate the Helicoprion 0 out of 2. It just means carve meat off it, right? Just carve meat off of it. No big deal. Let's go see what kind of gun we could have used. Could have gotten another gun enhancement kit. Probably would have saved us a couple shots. Ancient sea people statue. But I guess Dave's a little bit too riled up right now to really think, hey, I should take pictures of that. Or I should take a picture of this. Not sure what this is, really. It's like, looks like a sea person working at the base of some rock. I don't know. This bomb didn't do much good either, to be perfectly honest. It's like, oh boy, an extra 40 damage. Here is the last switch. It's larger than the one in the second room. Help me, Swamp. You can't do anything without me, human. Here we go. I think that once we get to the control room, that's like the last part of the game, right? We'll have fixed the whole problem with the sea people and the earthquakes and have stopped the meltdown and... Now we can go to the control room. Except the control room door is filled with rocks. Always something in this game. Good, I activated the last switch. The door to the control room should be open now. I must get out through the exit and see what's going on outside. Here's our convenient exit, so we don't have to go through that whole mess again. Check the control room entrance. You coming, Swamp? What are you doing, human? Go check the situation outside. Rude. Okay. I mean, you could come along. I'm sort of inviting you. Now, we got a very upgraded gun at the moment. We can't deploy the crab trap because we already did that. So, let's just hope that Dunkleostis doesn't eat us. Oh, we go check out the control room. Alright, there's a way out. Scooter, 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 scooter! I hope that our dumpling boost applies to that too. Yeah, it's all broke. Oh, those aren't rocks, those are roots. The control room is still closed. The door is stuck by the divine tree roots growing from inside. Are we gonna have to hurt the divine tree? How did you get here, John Watson? I knew you would be found here. John Watson, how did you follow me here? Made of eco-friendly materials and titanium. There is no place the Deccan 9 cannot reach. I saw a passage in a strange village, so I just broke through it. Ha ha ha. How'd he get in? You don't mind destroying this beautiful primordial place, do you? I can't believe it. You are a germ in this world, and I am about to sterilize you. What a hypocrite. I know what your sea blue did in secret. His eyes twitching. So it was you. That is why the description of the suspect perfectly matches you. I am suddenly very curious about how I was portrayed in that description. More reason I can't let you go free. I, John Watson of Sea Blue, the Guardians of the Sea, will rid the sea of impurity. Time to fight John Watson. How tenacious. We must finish our business with this one. How am I supposed to neutralize that sturdy submarine? With its own missiles, of course. I played Sonic 3. I know how this works. Oh! John Watson's missiles do less damage than that shark did. Haha, you are running like a rat. You can't evade this one, the Kirisame of Death. Cut shark? Note to self, look up what Kirisame means. Okay. Some kind of plesiosaur. That's a bit scarier than John Watson. Carnosaurus. I don't want to fight that. What is that? An ancient creature of the plesiosaurus family? Maybe a Carnosaurus? Unbelievable. A monster of that size hidden in the deep sea glacier? You'd think it would have unthawed by now since this water was too hot for us to swim in before. Fighting such a monster would be ridiculous. But if it has recently come out of the ice, it may be sluggish and weak. Besides, no way I can get to the control room without confronting it. Isn't that a missile launcher that came off John Watson's submarine? What if I can shoot it with the missiles? This doesn't seem like a good plan, but I guess it's better than nothing. My missile launcher fell in a very inconvenient place. And it won't work anymore. Okay, that seems to have unbroken the missile launcher. It shoots fire. How does it shoot fire? Probably have to hit it one more time. And I hate that I have to swim directly towards it to gain access to the weapon to fight it. That didn't finish it off. That's not great. I'm gonna run out of boost soon. And we're already out of oxygen. I don't have any other tools. I don't have any way to refill my oxygen, do I? There's no more clams. Can I just retreat? Ah, there's a clam. If I can get Dave near it. Well, we'll restart. Hopefully we still get our jetpack. Okay, that's bad, it's real bad. Like, I just cannot dodge this thing. Once it's aimed at me, I cannot move fast enough. I guess I'm lucky I'm taking less damage. Alright, let me refill the oxygen this time. That's good. They said it might be sluggish, but it doesn't seem that sluggish to me right now. Did it save the damage I did during the fight? What is this boss fight? It's some sort of plesiosaur. Krona something or other. I had to use a rocket launcher. It was really... They do a good job of making it so that you have to use some like weird little gimmick every boss fight. Almost every boss fight, anyway. It will be a nightmare if one of those monsters reaches land. It'll be a nightmare if those things just become something that's in the water. Like, I think that we got a lot of problems from this meltdown. Just releasing very large ancient creatures into the ocean. Anyway, gotta hurry to the Divine Tree control room and restore the device. But I still can't, because there's still roots in the way. What is this drone? Hey, Dave. Sorry, I'm late. I was making an explorer drone to aid you as the glacial area looked dangerous. And it has just been completed. Dr. Bacon, I didn't know the signal could reach this deep. Aha, it's the pride and joy of my lab. This drone not only communicates, but also does many activities underwater. Is one of those activities cutting divine tree roots? All thanks to Duff here. It's good to see you, Dave. Such a large glacial ice in this depth. It is as if it was touched by Gabriella and her cold fingers. Only if I could soothe her loneliness. I think the construction there, translators, is if only I could soothe her loneliness. Because we're making references to, what was that game? Not game. Comic. A comic got killed. Very effective depression them up. Anyways, it looks like the roots are blocking the door. The drone can cut roots using a laser cutter. Oh, isn't that handy? Haha, I foresaw your hardship and added the feature. Haha, lucky! Well, why don't you activate the laser cutter? I bet this works like our gluing and welding minigame. Nope. No, he's just gonna do it. The divine tree is extremely hard, unlike ordinary trees, which are only very hard. It will take 2 days to get done. Do your thing until I am done, and hope that the drone doesn't get eaten by a Dunkleosteus. I will let you know when I'm done. So, where'd the Kernosaurus fall? Buckbean. There should be something worth taking with me. I should explore the area. Okay, fine. I'll go carve out some chunks of the Kernosaurus. And then I guess we'll be done for the day. There, there's a Kernosaurus. And there's some more Kernosaurus. And I don't know what happened to John Watson. Maybe he's dead. I mean, there's his ship. I'm pretty sure John Watson's dead. I don't know what this is. They really could have added some, Septopod. Decapod? The six-limbed fish that were a thing back in the Devonian. Oh, you're hostile. I'm not gonna fight the Dunkleosteus. That would be stupid. But a Falcatus? Sure. Little hammerhead shark, but the hammer is more like an actual hammer and not its whole head. This guy looks neat. Some kind of worm? I'm a little surprised that this thing is hostile. I don't recognize it. Olympteris. Nope, don't know that one. Come here, you. Pikaia. I'm just gonna show you guys a Dunkleosteus if you haven't seen one before. That guy. Armored fish. The preserved parts are these parts, right here in the front. What we know about its tail and its fins are mostly based on, like, impressions, last I checked. Oh god. So we got a Greenland shark and a Dunkleosteus on me now. May as well catch a couple of these guys. Eventually we might get a breeding population going in my fish farm. They're so easy to catch though, they can't be worth much. Capelin. We should focus on getting out of here. I've come too close to drowning too many times. We got a lot of good stuff in our pockets. I'm just gonna go back to the boat. So all we gotta do is wait out 2 days for Duff's laser to cut through. Huh. The sleep grenade launcher counted towards grenade launcher. Nice to know. We got snow crab. Crops are all grown. Already, huh? Ah, these crops. So if we want, we can make vegetable sushi. Check the fish farm in the morning. For now, let's serve sushi and call it a day. Let's make up for spending literally all my money on an upgraded wetsuit. It's like, sorry, employees. I needed to be able to dive deeper. You'll understand, I'm sure. Price. Yes, we will do this. If we enhance it, it sells for 200 more a pop. But we'll make more money. We'll lose 800. We'll lose a lot of money in sales by not making that, so let's just put it out there as is. Expensive things. Glacial haddock. Good enough. Wait, what about these? Even better. Snow crab sushi. Starry puffers. Sells for a lot, but it's not very good. Arctic cod. Doesn't sell for much more, but it gets more to like the level of quality we expect. Alright, we might run out of food today, unless... Kaplan's. We'll save them for upgrades. Vampire squid sushi is not good. Let's make it better. Okay. It's not really enough to serve customers. Yeah, whatever. Let's just put this out there. And hope we do well, because we're broke. Dishes. Make sure we got enough wasabi still. And now I can do my cleaning duties, because the only thing that Dave's the only one that can do it. And I'm really bad at it. I always miss the rhythm on that second swing. So we didn't sell out of anything. People didn't buy very much of the vampire squid. We made a lot of money! Thank you, Vegetable Sushi. Probably need to make more vegetables. VIP visit. Oh yeah, I totally forgot about that. Okay, let me get ready to, mute the game audio if necessary. Check. Yo, what's up, Dave? You doing good? You seem energetic today.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. Can you come to the chicken farm real quick? I got something to show you.
No.
Okay. And Udo, what do you want? Wait, can I have a moment with you? Oh, you are that reporter from before. Do you need help with something? Thanks for your help. My boss entrusted me with a new project. I am sure a promotion will be in order. Well, anyways, tell me, sir, have you seen extremely novel fish inside the giant blue hole? You mean like all the monsters? Yeah, we've seen some pretty novel monsters. There are fish from many different locales in there. What do you mean by novel? I mean very peculiar fish, the sort no one's ever discovered before. We found a bunch of extinct things. Our magazine has a secret weapon, the fish radar. Most boats have a fish radar, dude. And it tells us that this blue hole is a treasure drove of... It's treasure trove, dude. Whatever. Of undiscovered species. We weekly fish are planning a series of specials over the next few months to showcase these precious new fish. It's called the Catch 'em All Project. No. That's copyrighted. You can't do that. We can research the fish on the weekdays, and if you can catch specimens for us on the weekends, they'll be featured in the specials we'll be publishing in the Weekly Fish every Monday. Yes, Monday. Me. Catch them. Well, you are kind of the only diver in these parts, aren't you? Other than sea blue people, yeah. And pirates. I'm not really following your logic. In any case, as we have to have the issues ready by Monday, You'll have to catch the specimens by Sunday evening at the latest. But that's tomorrow, isn't it? This is just too sut. Now then, let's get down to business. The fish we spotted with our radar this week was... the humphead parrotfish, but with a hat. A horned parrotfish. I've never seen anything like that.
Yeah?
The location is close to the boat wreck. That's what I can detect. Oh, and... I'll give you this fish tracker. If there's a fish mond you can need to catch nearby, it'll vibrate and play a sound. Oh, that also sounds copyrighted. You're gonna get some trouble, Udo. Don't be surprised. Guess what this device can do? Make phone calls? It allows you to see all the information about fish, even when diving in the water. You can see your best grade fish, how many fish you have in your restaurant and fish farm, and more. Is that right? But how is that possible when I didn't link my device yet? Yeah. You're a bit clueless, aren't you? By the way, good luck then. It's till Sunday, or tomorrow evening to be precise. This is sudden work for a magazine. Come to think of it, I think I've seen the boat wreck in passing. Yeah, we know where that is. Strange creatures will sometimes appear in the giant blue hole. They're called fishmon and are anything but easy to catch. Get information from the journalist Udo, who comes on Saturdays. We got new content. From now on, you can use Fish Tracker underwater with Tilde. One more key to remember. Use this device to count the number of ingredients from the fish farm and sushi restaurant and check the grade of the fish you catch while you're still in the water. But we're not going to do all that right now. We're going to call it a day. So thanks for hanging out with me. I think we're finally getting to the final stretch in this game. And we just gotta wait until the end of this weekend for the story to start again. So I guess we're just catching fish. Maybe we'll try to find those fish that we made for Michael Baum, or whatever his name was. But I'm gonna go. So have a good one. I'll be back tomorrow, not playing this game. Bye for now.